Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for joining the earnings call of JK Paper for Q2 FY22. We have with us today the management team comprising Mr. A.S. Mehta, President and Director, Mr. V. Kumaraswamy, CFO, along with the other team members. So we'll start with brief opening remarks from the management, following which we'll open the call for Q&A. I request to limit one question per participant in the first two rounds. Later, we can take more questions if time limit permits. I'll now turn the call over to Mr. Mehta for his opening remarks. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Okay. Thank you so much, Archana ji, for arranging this call. And also thank you that you allowed other selling side, buying side work to attend this call. That's been, we should be extra thankful to you there. And welcome all the participants. And many thanks as well as best of Diwali greetings to you all for the happy Diwali, and have a great time. And I hope the year has been great for you all, and we also pray that one more year of greatness in stock markets will respond. And it was very good observation by you, Archana ji. I think one question per person in the first and second round, I think, will enable more participants to ask the questions. After that, maybe, we can go into n number of questions per person and, let it not get monopolized, at least in the initial stage. Good. And what I would request is I will ask Mr. Anil Jatana to run through the corporate presentation first, and so that everybody has that basic information, and we don't have to repeat the first information which is already available. Jatana, you can start our presentation. Is it visible to you all?
Yes, sir, it's visible.
Okay, that's
good. Afternoon to all. So this is a presentation we have uploaded just yesterday only. So all of you can, I think maybe most of would have gone through this. So I will just run through quickly, and we will more focus on the question answers to give more time to the everyone. So this is a JK organizations. We have business in paper, cement, tire, seeds, and more than 100 years organizations. And most of the businesses are very, have a long history also. We have in dairy products also. We have CSR activities, hospitals, even university also, and in medical also. We are US dollar 4 billion group with 30 manufacturing plants and more than 100 countries with more than 40,000 employment. So JK Paper has a history of more than 75 years, almost 80 to 83 years now. So started in 1938 and now we are 2021 with production of almost 3,600 metric tons per annum, and now we are at almost 7.5 lakh ton post expansion at our Surat facility. So this is just a shareholding patterns with promoters holding about 50% and institutions about 6.5%. Individuals, which is a major
promoters, 49.5%.
Yeah. So 49.5% promoters. So we have three plants, one in eastern part of the country, which is in Odisha, largest plant in JKPM. Surat is the second in Gujarat, which is in western part of the country. And Sirpur, which is the central one in Telangana, which latest we acquired 3 years back. So three plants are there, JKPM and CPM in JK Paper, and Sirpur is subsidiary company. And we are the market leader in copier paper with about 25% market share in copier paper. And coated paper about 11% and packaging board about 11%. And packaging board market share will increase further after commissioning of our new plant at Surat. So this is where volume will come in going forward. So we have already discussed there are three plants, one on the eastern part, JKPM, western Gujarat, and then Telangana Sirpur, which we acquired 3 years back. So we have today capacity of about 5.9 lakh ton, and post our ongoing expansion in Surat, it will go up to 7.6 lakh ton. So we have All India Distribution Network in copier, led by our participation in the retail also. And we have more than 18 warehouses, more than 350 trade partners and over 4,000 dealers. So this is a turnover. So first time we have reached 1,000 crore rupees for the quarter, the Q2 current financial year. And EBITDA is 237 crore and PAT is 118 crore rupees for current quarter, the September quarter Q2. So this is the comparison over corresponding quarter and 6 months. So our turnover is 1,000 crore rupees, 1,001 crore rupees compared to the corresponding of 702 crore rupees. Of course, it was lower because of COVID also corresponding quarter. But this quarter, we also have a additional volume from Sirpur, which has also contributed to the top line. So EBITDA is 237 crore rupees against 157 crore rupees corresponding quarter. And PAT is 118 crore rupees versus 68 crore rupees corresponding quarter. And EBITDA margin is 25% against 24.6% corresponding quarter. And 6 months, EBITDA margin is 27% against 23% corresponding half year. And our top line is roughly increased by 43% in the Q2 as well as half year. And EBITDA increased by 51% and 73% in quarter and half year. And PAT increased by 74% in the quarter and 132% in the 6 months over the corresponding periods. So this is a quarter on quarter. So you see the EBITDA margins, it has increase, I mean, it is now 25%. So for the 6 months, it is 27%. So this is realizations. Actually, our realizations have increased, especially in the packaging board and coated paper in last few quarters. So packaging board has increased by almost 4 to 5% in this quarter. And coated paper number is not here. So coated paper number is not here. So that also has increased by 34% in this quarter, over the corresponding quarter. And this quarter also, it is increased by 1.5%. Uncoated, this is a stagnation in the realizations. So this is a continuous improvement. Actually, in the last 5 years, we have given some index. On manufacturing cost has increased by about 8 to 9%, mainly led by increase in coal prices, chemical prices, and the impact of other commodities. Realizations has utilization has increased compared to the last year also as well as quarter also. So 105 is this is the index actually over the 100 which is in FY 2017. Interest rates have further come down over the last year also, 72 compared to the 76 in terms of index compared to the FY 2017. And ROC has increased annualized to 17.8% compared to the last full year, about 13.2%. This is a 4% deleveraging. Of course, there is some amount of increase in the debt because of our Surat plant, which is going on, and additional debt which we have taken for this project. So if you see the last 3-4 years, of course, net debt EBITDA has come down substantially. Similarly, net debt equity also has come down, and interest coverage has increased up. In between, in FY21 only it came down because of the lower EBITDA, because of the impact of COVID and all. Otherwise, it has again going up already. And we have AA- rating from CRISIL as well as India ratings also, which we are able to maintain even apart from not good last year because of the impact of COVID, but we are able to maintain that. This is the last full year number which we have discussed earlier also. So utilization is 103%. And current quarter, we have a utilization of 110%, 110.5%. And of course, thrust on plantation, which is our mantra actually, which 100% now we are getting from our local catchment of our plants, both our plants. And of course, the similar will happen in the Sirpur also going forward, which we have already started that path to reach. Rating we already say, and JKPM has also received energy efficient unit for the last year, which we have discussed earlier. So this we have seen actually in last 10 years how we have increased our capacity and net sales and total assets also, and equity has increased by 13 times, turnover 4.1 times, volume has increased by three times, assets have increased almost 6 times, so I think 7 times. The farm forestry, which is one of our mantra, so we keep on increasing the acreage. And if you see in 10 years back, so it used to be around 6,000 to 7,000 per hectare per annum, which has increased to 17,000 in between, and it's around in the average of 13,000 now. And 100% of our wood is coming from our local catchment area of the plant, so which used to be 5 years back 50%, so which is one of the reasons that our raw material cost has come down substantially in last 4-5 years. So these are some of the CSR activities which we are doing. So we are covering almost 578 villages, 4 lakh plus direct beneficiaries, and we have incurred about 10.35 crore rupees in last year on all the CSR activities, which about 70% of the COVID related claims. So I think we can, these are the balance sheet which you can go through, and of course in the question answers also we can discuss a few of them. So we can, unless you have any questions in the presentation, we can go to the question answer.
Good. Thank you, Anil, for that quick wrap up of our conditions. Sachana ji, I think you
sure,
want
sir.
To make opening comments?
Yeah. Sure. So let's start the Q&A session. Okay. And then I'll ask my questions again if the time permits.
Sure,
so yeah. I request somebody who has joined from Latinum Capital to go ahead.
Hi, thank you. And thank you for the presentation, gentlemen, and congrats on a very good quarter. My first question is, if we see end of August, the CBIC has extended the ADD on copier paper by only 3 more months up till the end of February on imported copier paper from Indonesia and Singapore. Now, why has this been extended only by 3 months? Is it a provisional order? Are you expecting a longer tenure of ADD? And if this, hypothetically, if this ADD goes away on our copier paper, what sort of realization hit might we see if there is sort of a normalization of shipping container freight costs in, say, 6 months?
It is February only because the investigation was going on. The first hearing has taken place. So since in view of the COVID protocol, they were expecting this, the investigation may take some more time. So that is the reason it has been extended up to February. But certainly our petition is for at least 3 years. So that is where the subject is. As far as the competitiveness and also the scenario is concerned, you are right. As right now, it is the ocean freight, which is also one factor, because the landed cost of any paper today is much higher than what the domestic prices are. So this is one scenario. And is also one more thing is that now in India, the copier paper, there is a mandatory BIS marking. So, and the BIS, the registration and the BIS approval is only for the Indian companies today. So that is also one fact needs to be kept in mind.
Understood. And just another question on the 2%, close to 2% stake reduction by the promoters this quarter. Any reason for that linked to liquidity needs elsewhere or any other specific reason for that? Or could you care to comment on why they did this?
See, as you yourself said that is there any liquidity need or something? So it is so the promoters, their own thought process. Certainly, they are committed for this business for a long term basis. So these may be, I mean, they invest and they divest to some extent based on their own need.
Let's go to the next person now. We can come to him in case he has further
queries. Thank you.
I request Mr. Sriman to go ahead.
Yeah. Good afternoon, gentlemen. Am I audible?
Yeah, good afternoon.
Yeah. So just wanted to check on, you know, the inflation in the raw material prices, both the chemicals as well as the power. And how are we passing on those prices? How much of that inflation have you already passed on? And, you know, what could be the impact on the margins in the near term? Thank you.
Okay. See, as far as we are concerned, so the commodity prices and the energy prices, these two counts, there is certainly an impact. I would say that these commodities and the energy put together would be somewhere around 15% of our cost, right? So there is certainly the impact to the extent of that component of 15% of our total cost. Our basic raw material of wood or pulp, there is no much impact. Rather, the pulp prices have come down to some extent. So there is some advantage in our packaging board. So this is one scenario. To the extent of this impact of the energy and the other commodity prices, I would say that to the extent of whatever impact was there up to the month of October, that we could pass it on in the market. But what is going to be the scenario in the month of November, December, it is difficult to predict at this stage.
Sure. Thank you. I'll get back in the queue.
Next, we have Mr. Rahul Chopra. Sir, please go ahead.
Hi, everyone. Sir, a very simple question on the uncoated paper prices. You can give us a flavor of where the prices are and what are the drivers going forward? And have we taken any price hikes in this quarter?
See, the uncoated paper prices were very much... I would suggest that all other people, those who are not speaking, please keep their mic mute. So, see, the scenario is that before the COVID wave 2, there were the sudden drop in the prices because there was a depressed demand in the market. So, there were price drop. And so, once the recovery took off in the market, there was opportunity to correct the prices of the paper, uncoated paper, particularly as you are asking. So we could correct the prices in the month of July also, August also, September also, depending on the different variety. And also in the month of October, we have taken some price correction, which will be effective from 1st of November. So I would only say that more or less, we are back to a pre-COVID price level right now. And in some category, we may be shared better because there is a input cost pressure.
So pre-COVID price, how much would that be? Would that be 60 rupees per kg?
Yeah, it was copier paper. It was slightly higher than 60. 60 but
1.9,
so 62, 63 was the level. And more or less, we are back to that level. And Maplito, certainly, it was at one point of time, it was 61. And right now, it would be close to 59, 60 now again.
Understood. And going forward, like, what would be the drivers which will affect this price? How do we look at that?
See, suddenly the demand and supply scenario will be a driver. But at the same time, if the market is favorable, then the energy prices, if there is a further escalation of energy prices, then certainly that will have to be passed on.
Got it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Next, I invite Mr. Dhruv Beda to go ahead.
Thank you. Good afternoon, sir. My question is on recently JK Paper has bought a stake in Dipti Electronics and Electro Optics Company. So can you please comment on this acquisition and how will this acquisition aid JK Paper?
I think last time also it was answered. As you know, as you can see, we have some cash to spare in our balance sheet, and we had expanded in the uncoated segment in 2013-14, as well as in packaging board. A new project is coming up, fairly big project. And as you know, the growth rates in the uncoated paper segment, copier, is about 4-5%. And the packaging board right now is doing well, and maybe we'll consider some additional investments there. But to use our cash flows, we also had to, you know, look at other opportunities as well. Obviously, we will continue to grow in paper, but in other aspects as well. As you know, this is a very promising industry, very good growth rates. A number of things are being done by the government also. They have also announced that we'll procure 68,000 crores or some such thing for the defense. And this is a small investment to test the waters and see, you know, where we are and how we, you know, perform there. And if you know, if it is paying off and the experience is good, maybe we can think of small diversification there also. Plus, they also have some synergies in terms of industrial IoT, and you know, they are into image sensing and vision sensing, etc. Plus some algorithms. So if there is some synergy in our plantation manufacturing operations, etc., we will also use them. A small investment of around 25 crores. So what taking a chance there was the logic.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much, sir. I come back in the queue.
Now I request Mr. Amit Doshi to go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. You recently in your interview, you mentioned that, you know, the global pulp prices are down about $550-$580. So can you, I mean, you know, what is the current status? Because we believe that logistical issues are still not much resolved. So what is the reason that this global pulp prices came down quite down, almost, you know, 15% or so? And any thoughts on that?
See, what I said was in my interview, this $570 or $580, it is for the mechanical pulp I mentioned. And the chemical pulp, certainly the prices are in the band of $650, which at one point of time at peak level, that was $800. So it has come down. See, $800 price is not a price which is sustainable at any point of time. This was because of some kind of a mismatch, some kind of the speculative scenario in China. But otherwise, the sustainable prices for the chemical pulp is somewhere around $550 to $600. And it is right now, it is ruling at $650, $640. And that too because of the ocean freight. If the ocean freight normalizes, the prices in any case would come down to a sustainable level of $500 to $550 a ton. This is one scenario. The second is the BC, the mechanical pulp. As I said, that the prices have come down to $560, $570, but that is also not sustainable. It has to be somewhere around $500 a ton. So that gap is also because of the ocean freight. Once the container and the ocean freight scenario normalizes, it should be somewhere around $500 to $520 or so. Slightly some easing out has happened as far as the container availability is concerned, some. But I think it will take another 6 months' time before it gets totally normalized.
Okay. So this chemical pulp is something that we used for our packaging board plant?
No, chemical pulp is, this is what we produce. But when there is some kind of a higher use of chemical pulp, then we import for any use. Because that chemical pulp is, you use it for paper or board, does not make any difference. It is a mechanical pulp which is only used in the packaging board.
Okay. But then in that case, then in last two quarters, you know, the presentation indicates that there has been significant improved realization in the packaging board division.
Yes.
So then if the prices have come down, so isn't there any direct link between those pulp prices and our packaging board prices, or how does
it work? See, the packaging board prices, there is a time gap always. So when the pulp prices move up, that also immediately you don't get the price increase. You get the price increase after a quarter. And when there is a price drop, to some extent, there may be a price correction downward also. But at the same time, this time, the pulp prices certainly came down, but at the same time, energy cost has gone up. The coating material, chemical cost has gone up. So there is no downward trend of packaging board prices.
Okay. And these are, so we keep inventory for around 1.5 months to 3 months. What is our inventory general?
See, the pulp inventory, normally it is kept, since it is a purchased pulp, and the ocean, the transit time itself is something around 30 to 45 days. So we keep inventory of 30 to 45 days. But there are, all the time, there are some inventory in the pipeline. So on an average, our inventory would be 30 to 45 days.
Okay, thank you. I'll get back in the queue. Thank you.
Next person, Akshana, I think, has dropped out, I think. Maybe. Who shall we take the next person?
So the next question would be from Pritesh Chheda.
Okay.
Yeah, sir, thank you for the opportunity. Sir, just on the cost rise and the price hikes that have been taken, what we saw is that October is now running at an all-time high paper prices. In fact, my guess is in some of the cases surpassed as well. Now, considering those price hikes and the RM increases that you talked about, where 15% of the RM has seen inflation, are your price hikes trending ahead of the inflation that you are seeing? And sometime in the past, let's say when the peak pricing was there, we had a construct of, let's say, a $900 paper price and $700 pulp price at that point in time, where the margins were, on a higher band of 26 to 28%. So is that the construct which we are seeing incrementally, or the RM inflation is still higher than the price rise which have happened for the industry and for us?
No, I would say that the input inflation is not higher than the price, since there is a good demand in the market. So in fact, the realization is better than the input prices.
Okay. The benefit of the price increase, though the pricing had started improving in quarter two, is it that the benefit of the old price increases will slow down in the incremental quarters, and cost came first in the quarter two and price realization benefit should slow down incrementally?
What is the question?
I'm saying that the cost increases came in quarter two, but the realization benefit which the industry is taking and which you are taking will slow down in the incremental quarters?
No, this is what I said, that the NSR increase is better than the input cost increase.
Incrementally, or was it a construct for quarter two? I think quarter two.
I'm saying quarter two as well as and coming quarter as well.
So then why was there some impact on the margin for us if that's the case?
See, what you see the margin? Margin impact is when you have more volume from Sirpur, then the denominator is a bigger number. Okay. So the EBITDA of Sirpur, which is certainly lower, and that is not reflected in standalone profitability of JK Paper.
Okay.
Because that EBITDA is reflected in the Sirpur profitability. So when the denominator is higher, the percentages you will see a lower, as you see the 25% compared to previous, the Q1 itself was 26-27% or 28%. Whereas the per se, the profitability of Q2 would be better, standalone JK Paper. But since the Sirpur volume is there as a denominator, the percentages, it will look the smaller.
Okay, understood. So which means that you are at your peak profitability on your JK Paper business, but it's because of Sirpur is why we don't see that percentage number appear. Yeah.
I don't know whether this is a peak or you have many, many more peaks at any different point of time.
Okay. So sir, just one clarification. Between quarter one and quarter two, so quarter one had without Sirpur numbers at 660 crore and quarter two 945 with Sirpur. That's how.
Quarter one was also Sirpur with Sirpur number, but the Sirpur number was pretty small.
Okay. So just last, can you help us with the volumes then? The bridge of the volume for quarter one and quarter two for JK Paper and Sirpur separately?
I mean, that we don't publicly disclose. So it's better that that's not information available in the public domain.
No. Yeah. But sir, then for the 610,000 ton capacity that we have, which is Sirpur plus JK Paper put together, were we using 100% utilization in the quarter two?
No, quarter two also, when we are talking capacity utilization 110 or 108, it is only standalone JK Paper. It is not Sirpur. Sirpur, to my mind, we did
70%. 70%, yeah.
So 100, 110 for JK and 70 for Sirpur.
Correct.
Okay. And lastly, sir, what is the update on the boards plant now, when it is going to get operational?
See, the board plant, as I mentioned in my previous, the other interviews also, and it is in the public domain, that the trials are going on. And because these are massive projects, massive machines, and very complex processes, so it takes time. So the trials are going on, and hopefully the machine would be stabilized soon. And the pulp mill, the trials will start only end of this month.
Okay. Pulp mill will start end of this month. Yes. And you
trials will start. As I said, trials will start in pulp mill end of this month.
You should reach peak utilization, in your opinion, when?
Not this year, next year.
Next year. Okay. Sir, lastly, this one clarification. This 70% utilization which you mentioned for Sirpur in quarter two, what it would be in quarter one? Quarter one would be significantly lower?
Yes, I think it was much lower.
So 60%.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Next person.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
The next question would be from Ms. Ritu.
Shoot your question, please.
Hello. May I request Ms. Ritu to please go ahead with the question? There is no. Hello. As there is no response, we can move forward with Nishit Shah's question.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, most of my questions are answered. I need one clarification. So in the opening remarks, you said that coated paper realizations were up quarter on quarter. So can you please quantify that again?
See, the coated paper prices are moving up predominantly because one is that there is a pent up of demand and sizable demand increase because of this festival season, all these New Year diary calendar and other thing. So there was a much greater demand. At the same time, the supply line from China and Indonesia, those are disrupted because of the ocean container availability and the freight scenario. So that has led to a price increase. And to my mind, the price increase would be in the vicinity of from a level of, let's say, 50 rupees a ton level, 50 rupees a kg level, it would be close to 30% to 40% increase.
64 now, so be 50. Approximately
now 28%. Still more in the next
quarter. Bulk of it happened in the first quarter. Second quarter, there is still an increase, maybe about a couple of percentage points.
Okay, that's great. And sir, in the packaging segment, post Q2, did we see any increase in realization? And if you can quantify that. Thank you.
See, the packaging board also, the prices have been increased because of the input cost pressure of energy and other things. And so hopefully we have done one more price increase in October, which will be effective from November.
Last quarter, there was an increase of around 5% and it calls for some more correction.
Yes.
Cost inflation will not be recorded.
That's all, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
The next question is from Mr. Anupam.
Good afternoon, sir.
Very good afternoon.
My question is on the that the pulp pricing is now coming down. Where do we see our competitiveness against the imported paper? As in, to be precisely say, what was the level of price difference as in the landed cost and our cost?
See, predominantly pulp prices, market pulp prices, there is no direct correlation with the paper prices. Not direct, because most people, those who are exporting paper to India, they are integrated player. Most. There are some, those who are not integrated, they produce paper out of the pulp, purchase pulp. But otherwise, most people are integrated player. And the globally paper prices depend on the other input costs as well as the demand and supply scenario in the market. So the global paper prices before COVID touched as high as $900 a ton. And there were no other reason. I mean, it was simply a good demand, lower production, lower availability. So the prices were much higher. Also, that time, the pulp prices were close to $650 to $700. So right now, also, the pulp prices are $650. So if we have the same corollary, then the paper prices should also be at the $850. But the fact remains, other than the ocean freight factor, the paper prices globally are not $850 or $800. They are lower, but since the container availability is an issue, so the landed cost of paper is higher. Let's say today, the landed cost of paper in US, because of the container freight, is something around $1,000 or $1,100 a ton, which was never be the scenario in US. So it depends on the so many other factor of the demand and supply. More demand and supply plays a role in the global paper prices than the pulp prices.
Just to add to what he's saying, the one-to-one kind of correlation, that two quick adjustment, you will find only imported paper in India.
And sir, what's the pricing scenario in that?
Second, sorry?
What is the cost scenario and pricing scenario in that segment in terms of imported and domestic cost?
See, this is what I said, that the domestic cost, right now the imported coated paper is available at somewhere around $900, $950 or $1,000. So that means the price of something around 75, 80 rupees, right? And maybe more also with some landed port expense and other thing. But the domestic prices are close to 70, 71, 72.
Okay.
But as I said, that it has no relation with the pulp.
Okay. Got it. Thank you, sir. I'll join back.
Okay. Thank you.
Can we have the next question from Mr. Deepak?
Who's going next? Hello?
Can you have next question from Sir Deepak
Lalwani, please? Yeah, thank you for the opportunity. Sir, I wanted to understand, you know, what is our dependence on black liquor and coal for our energy consumption? What is the split?
No, there is no dependence of black liquor. In fact, black liquor is our own byproduct, I would say, which is a biomass coming from our own wood used for pulping. And that is used as a fuel in our boiler. So today, I would say that total energy needs is met out of the black liquor is close to 55 to 60%. So 40%, I would say, we are dependent on the fossil fuel, means the coal.
Got it. And sir, this 40%, is this, do we have any linkage with the with Coal India and Sigrini, or is it imported coal?
No, no. Yes, we have the linkage. We have linkage at our both the plant. But is the question is not linkage. Question is availability out of the linkage also. See, right now, all the Coal India and all the mines, they are only supplying to the power plant. They are not supplying even against the linkage. Our allocation is pending.
Right. Sir, and also, if I just wanted to clarify. So we took 5% price hike in September, which will flow in this quarter. And what is the quantum of price hike that you have taken in October?
See, in October also, I would say that the price hike would be close to 4 to 5% in the uncoated category.
Okay.
And packaging board would be slightly less than 5%.
Okay. So, sir, with, you know, the imported coal price coming down and if the caustic price is almost stable, so our margins shouldn't be low even in the Sirpur plant in Q3, right?
No, no, caustic price is very stable. It is going day by day after day.
Right. So with the price increases, will you be able to cover that and, you know, maintain the profitability in the Sirpur plant as well? Because you mentioned that Sirpur is at a lower utilization and at a lower margin rate.
No, I would say that in case Sirpur case, to my mind, the there would be advantage of higher price, because the input cost increase is lower than the NSR increase.
Okay, got it.
Thank you.
Now I request Mr. Anshul to go ahead with his question.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, Anshul.
Yeah, hi sir. So actually, I wanted to ask that on the BIS marking point, that you mean that so will that BIS certification practically stop the imports, or because foreign companies will not be able to take the BIS marking? So can you just elaborate us on the same?
No, you yourself said this, no? There is no BIS license given to the overseas player till date. So without BIS, they cannot sell their product in the country.
Okay, so
as has been applicable for many other products in the country, like tire also, without BIS, you cannot sell tire from Indonesia, China, Thailand, anywhere. If they have BIS, they can only sell.
Okay, sir. So no more imports. So there will be a price difference.
At this point of time, I would say yes. And when they apply for BIS, once the BIS is granted to them, then only they can sell the product.
Okay. Okay, sir. Got it. Thank you. I'll get back into the queue.
Now, I request Mr. Kush Ganga to go ahead with this question.
Sir, our net debt as on September is around 2,000 crores. Can it be said that considering the trials are going on at packaging board, can it be said that it has peaked from current levels, it should go down?
Yeah, what is the net debt you said? It's not 2,000. I don't know which year you are talking about. September is 2000.
Yes, correct.
September. Okay. Yeah. What is your question?
Earlier, we had targets of net debt of around 2700 crores, right? So currently, it is around 2000 crores.
No, but the 27 crore net debt was consolidated.
Yes.
And what you are talking is the standalone 2000 crore. So I think that's the only interpretation issue, how do you see this? So net debt even today for JK Paper standalone, it is 2000 crore and the consolidated 26 or 2500 crore, right?
Also, some of the project loan that under disbursement, so first we have infused our equity, so maybe some disbursement will come, but it will not reach to that standalone 2000.
I think 2600 crore would be the peak now.
Yeah.
which were not the net debt for us? No, consolidated.
Consolidated 2,500 might go up to 2,700.
Yeah, this is what 2,600, 2,700 would be the peak.
Okay, got it. And considering the current higher prices versus earlier levels for packaging board, what can be the revenue at full capacity for this new plant? It should be significantly higher versus earlier, right?
See, earlier we said that it would be close to 1150 to 1200 crore. And if the prices move slightly more, I mean, maybe 5% higher. So even if it can be 1250 to 1300 at best.
Okay. And margins for this plant should be better than our current margins. Would that assumption be right?
See, the margin would be better when we stabilize and use 100% of capacity. See, it depends on what kind of a capacity utilization and the ramp up is there after the stabilization.
Yes, at full utilization, I was talking
about that. Full utilization, certainly the margin would be higher.
Okay. And sir, last question, what would be the interest and depreciation impact? Currently, it would be capitalized for this new plant. What would be that impact from Q3 or Q4 that would hit our P&L?
We have to look at when the plant is commercially fully commissioned. So you take the amount of 2,000 and calculate back, out of which about 1,500 is the borrowing. And you can assume about 7.2 to 7.3 as the interest rate. And depreciation, you take the normal depreciation around 4%.
Okay, thank you.
Now I request Mr. Rahul Chopra to go ahead with this question.
Kya bola? Depreciation ka kya?
Depreciation 4% average you take on the project cost.
Hi, sir. My question is also on the similar lines. I want to understand the economics of the CAPEX which you have done. The CAPEX cost is around 1950 or 2000 crores.
Yeah.
What is the ROI which you are targeting on a basis which is normalized after 2 years, for example?
See, whenever we do any project, our assumption is that it should be ROI should be more than 12 to 13%. And this is what the assumption for this project is also. And it depends sometime what kind of a external situation is. That means the market factors, as also some kind of assumption on the price and the selling prices. So let's see. Our assumption is that it should be somewhere around 12% or so.
Actually, we are targeting more. Yeah. 4% over. Average weighted average cost of capital, it should return more actually.
But that being said, is it not better to look at maybe opportunities which are inorganic in nature where you might get better return on your investment?
See, when you think about this, always the other side looks to be different. So you tell me which business gives you better return?
Consistent.
See, it has to be a sustainable return, and also there may be good year and bad year, but going forward for a longer term and the new capex for initial period of 5-10 years, the return would be 12-14%. Thereafter, there may be better return. Yes.
Rahulji, let me come to your question a little different way. We have had this experience in Orissa where the new, brand new, latest technology machine is very, very way ahead of the existing stock of machines. If you are talking about inorganic machines, the latest available will be, I mean, barring one of the eastern side competitor, which we may not go to. The others are 2012 or 11. So the next 10 years, there are a lot of significant improvements they have made, and the benefit of which we will lose. These machines run much faster, much better efficiency, lower consumption of electricity, water, and other, sometimes chemicals as well. They have finishing properties which are far better than the previous machines. So, one has to factor in all this. This is the, investment objective he's talking. And in the last project also, we have seen that where we have arrived and compared to what our projections, there was a significant gap. We do hope a similar kind of, you know, numbers will be delivered in this project also. But however, it will be difficult to commit anything in upfront.
Correct.
Understood. And just one last question, sir. I assume, let's say, 12 months from now, I think the company will throw free cash flow of more than, let's say, 800 crores. What would be the use of the free cash flow in your mind? I mean, how much would be towards dividends? How much would be towards other uses in your mind?
So what is the repayment next year, Anil?
So next 3 years, we have about average
350 to 400.
Including Sidhpur.
So the utilization of this towards, you know, the repayment of loans, etc., will be around 350 to 400 per annum. And dividends, you can say 40% means, you know, the amount last year, about 68-69 crores it was. And the balance, the board and the management will have to decide where to infuse these funds and this one. Otherwise, we might look for reduction of debt faster than what we anticipated.
Is it possible to increase the dividends, or
that is the decision which the board has to take. I can't comment on this, investors forum.
Understood. Thanks for your time. Thank you.
Due to time constraint, we'll take last two questions. Now I request Mr. Rahul Chopra to go ahead with your question, please.
No, the previous question was from me. I'll just lower my hand.
Sure. Mr. Jatin, can you please go ahead?
Thank you for the opportunity. So just wanted to understand what is the inventory in the system, because you said that the increase in the coated paper prices were largely due to the festive season because of printing of the diary and everything. So net basis, if we want to exclude this festive season phenomena, what is the inventory in the system and when can we see the demand going up back to pre-COVID level?
No. See, there is a different question from your side. One is the inventory and other one is the demand. So the demand is already pre-COVID level, I would say. Right? So that is one part. As far as the inventory is concerned, in the month of, I would say, June, there was inventory accumulation because of the COVID wave 2. There was a sizable inventory, and in fact, we were sitting on the inventory of something around close to more than 30 days inventory. But in the month of the July, August, September, there was a good traction. The demand was good. Market was favorable. So there was an inventory correction. So inventory came down. And I hope to reduce further inventory in the month of October, November, December.
In fact, just to add, I think, it has become an insignificant number in the overall scheme of things. The operating cycle, I think the working capital will be even negative, no? Only for operations.
Yes.
That is, data stops.
Absolutely. Yes.
It's almost negative. It's a thing which, need not bother you that it will never, interfere the prices or influence the prices. That may not happen, actually.
So thank you for your answer. And also one more question on the follow-up on the Sidhpur, which previous participants also are. So we operate at 70% utilization. So on what level can we assume that the Sidhpur will be a PAT positive from the full year basis? And now given the writing and printing paper, how do we see the operation turning around for us as a whole?
To my mind, at 80-85% level, it should be the PAT positive, Sidhpur.
So that means for next quarter onward, we can see some contribution coming from Sidhpur?
No, last quarter itself, in fact, at that level also, the Sidhpur was PAT positive.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. And we'll take our last question for today's call from Mr. S.B. Bhaiya. Please go ahead, sir.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
I just wanted to ask you that you have just said that trials are going on for the new capacity. So when do you hope to commission it? Is it in this quarter or the next quarter?
See, as I said, that it's very difficult because these are massive machines and massive projects. So we will have to see, I mean, what kind of a continuous trial, then the quality of the product and the machine behavior. All these factors we will have to see during this quarter as a trials. And then we need to decide, I mean, the which one is the final date when we say that now the plant is fully commercially capitalized.
Also, there are two clear sections, pulping and paper. As he said, pulping has not even started operations. So both of them will have to synchronize. So we'll let you know as soon as...
But based on the current progress, you are not in a position to tell that. Is it likely this quarter or the next quarter?
No, can't say. This quarter at least can't say.
Okay, and the next question is, when do you see the plant utilization in Serpur to improve from 70% to maybe closer to 100%? Is it this year or the next financial year?
See, the Serpur capacity, I would say that this quarter also we should be touching something around 75 to 80% this quarter itself. And next quarter, I mean, we hope to be near to 90%.
Okay, so your new boiler and other renovations are practically over?
Yes. Those are
the over. CapEx cycle is more or less over now.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you all for joining and happy Diwali. And thanks, IDBI, for hosting this meet.
So thank you so much for giving us this opportunity and wish you a very happy Diwali. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everybody, for joining it, and you may disconnect the call now.